I have. I met Frank Sinatra a couple of times.
Oh, my
God. I was singing at his 75th birthday party, and I was a kid. I'm sorry.
That is a very different thing to just meeting him. Being booked to sing at his birthday party.
Well, I hadn't planned on actually meeting him, so I went on stage, and there were some of the greatest singers in the world were at this event. In fact, Ella Fitzgerald was sitting backstage, she was sitting by herself, and she was kind of rocking back and forth, and I went up to her. And I said, "Miss Fitzgerald, are you okay?" She goes, "Oh, yes, it's just I'm terribly nervous." I'm thinking, "You nervous?"
Right.
So I sang my song, but I completely forgot the words because he was sitting right where you're sitting. And I felt so embarrassed about it that after the show, I saw him in the hotel going to his elevator to go up to his room. And I ran after him with my then girlfriend, now wife, Jill. And I said, "Listen, Mr. I saw him go in the elevator. I said, Jill, I got to go talk to him." She said, "You better leave him alone because he wants to be alone." So I took Jill and I got into the elevator. And it was Frank Sinatra and Barbara Sinatra and me and Jill. And the elevator doors closed. And I said, "Mr. Sinatra, I'm the kid that just sang for you. I forgot the words. I was really nervous. But I'm a lot better than what you just saw." And he listened to me for a second. And then he turns to Jill as the doors were opening. And he cradles her face in his hands and goes, "You're beautiful," and kisses her right on the mouth and leaves.